Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today I'd like to talk about a leak that just dropped a little while ago from Bob Network UK in regard to Black Ops 6, and that is theater mode potentially returning with Black Ops 6. Now once again, this is a leak. Make of that what you will, take it with a grain of salt, but I do love a discussion about theater mode because it's one of my favorite features that Call of Duty ever brought to the game. And we have not had it in a very long time. So for those of you that may not be aware, theater mode used to allow you to take games that you played. They would record in the background. These games would be stored in your theater mode. You could then go replay them, go free cam, look at all the other players, see how other people are playing. Theater mode also worked extremely well in private matches, and that was one of the biggest tools for me when it came to creating the Five Things series, getting different angles on, you know, bullets taking down Hellfire missiles and things of that nature, seeing a grenade bounce against another grenade. Trust me, it's possible. It happens in Call of Duty. All of these things can be recorded and then replayed back in the theater mode. So if something really, really cool happens and you're not capturing like all the time like content creators are, you will always have that as a backup. And well, I just really loved it altogether, and it was something that I really love to see return, especially now in 2024. I feel like there are so many different opportunities for them to improve the theater mode, maybe giving us a chance to swap out lenses per se. Say we're holding the camera, so we swap out a lens to give a different perspective, or bring back the dolly cam system, give us an opportunity to utilize filters or things like that. So there's really a lot of opportunity here for a full-fledged, fully fleshed out theater mode. And I bet you it even extends past Black Ops 6. I mean, think back to when we had Blackout. Theater mode worked in full matches of Blackout. Imagine having that for Warzone, being able to see how you died, or being able to check footage if you think something weird happened. You know, it's really going to be interesting to see how they manage to bring this back, because it's been gone for so long. Maybe it's just going to be a Black Ops 6 exclusive and it won't be in Warzone, but I think that people would be clamoring for it there. Either way, I am excited. Hopefully they still have them attached to private matches as well. I remember a really long time ago during E3, and I don't even remember what game it was. Maybe it was BO4, maybe it was BO3, but I remember being asked to join David Vonderhaar with two or three other content creators. We sat down for lunch, and the first question he asked us is, why do you guys want a theater mode? What would theater mode do for you as creators? What would theater mode do for players that aren't creators? And we had this really deep conversation about theater mode. We discussed how it can help creators and montage makers and people who just want to get better at the game go back and review their footage. Maybe something really cool happened and they can save the clip and upload it for people to like and upvote and things like that. But on the other hand, he also described how difficult it is to make theater mode a reality, which is why we haven't seen it in every single Call of Duty game. And to that, I totally understand. There's a lot of data involved when it comes to storing gameplays and things like that. I would imagine that the cost of running the servers at that point just rises exponentially, and that could definitely be a factor in why we haven't seen theater mode. But of course, with Microsoft and their own cloud system, I would imagine it goes hand in hand with, you know, storing gameplay. I also remember there was conversation at the time because Xbox One and PS4 were allowing you to record gameplay directly on the consoles, and why that is inferior versus a theater mode. With that, yeah, sure, you can record the gameplay, but theater mode lets you get into the gameplay. You can free cam around your character. As content creators, I can create thumbnails, I can create awesome videos, cinematic views, montage creation can happen. I mean, there's endless opportunity and possibilities, especially with the private match theater mode. Of course, I can't speak for everybody. There's some of you out there that maybe will never touch theater mode, so it's not as big of a deal to you, and maybe it's a feature that you don't even care about. Totally fine. I'd love to know what you think in the comment section below. But how I look at it is, if the system is there, the opportunity for them to create interesting events surrounding the theater mode is always there. Like, for example, back in the past with the original BO1, when Call of Duty Elite was being integrated into the game, they did theater mode contests, and if you uploaded a theater mode clip, you could be chosen to win a weekly prize. This could come in the form of bags, t-shirts. I think they even did a giveaway once for a Call of Duty Jeep. I could be mistaken on that. I remember one time I won a Call of Duty Fathead, one of those giant like decals that you stick on your wall. The Elite Skull was massive, and I had that on my wall for the longest time until I had to move and take it down. I wish they just made those so we can get them again. They were so cool. I think they had skateboard decks. And they did tennis shoes once, but the point is uploading a clip and getting the community involved and using the theater mode could definitely happen when that access is there for everybody. And now, since they have greater reach across not only Microsoft, but on their social media handles, and they're already doing things associated with the Call of Duty accounts, adding a theater mode on top of that is actually really cool. And I think it could create a lot of fun, natural engagement within the community itself. I think it's also a cool way as creators to do like those weekly clip shows that we used to see all the time, where it was just really good plays that were just generally recorded in theater mode. I tend to remember a time where there was a aggregated community page where the top clips would play and people could upload them, and every week it would change. And I don't know if we're ever going to actually get something like that ever again. One of the biggest problems when it came to the previous Call of Duty games with theater mode was people actually injecting the games with cheats via the theater mode. I'm not so sure that would be a problem nowadays. I don't think that that would actually be an issue at all, especially with Ricochet, but you can never really be too sure. And I guess that kind of goes hand in hand with other things that we've seen in the past that haven't made a return. You know, custom emblem creator, paint jobs, and things like that. We got a ton of creative people in our community, and we've seen them do some really incredible things when it comes to creating anime characters and the like. But then you also got the other side with the not so favorable words that get put on the weapon, and every time you get a kill, you see the kill cam of the person inspecting the weapon and it says something really bad on it. So that's probably one of the reasons why something like that will never return. And I think like copyright is a big thing nowadays. It used to be before, but even more so now, especially when it comes to user created items. But then I think about things like Forza and those created vehicles. I don't know. I think it's still possible. I think it's still a possibility. With Ricochet and all that, though, maybe it would help. Who knows if they take another crack at it. I guess the question to all of you out there now, still watching this video, is theater mode, emblem creator, things like that, do you want to see stuff like that return? Do you want more community-focused features returning? I definitely would. I would like to see a community tab with a bunch of, like, promoted paint jobs and emblems because they look really cool and unique. I'd love to see that for our characters even. Let us create our characters and give them unique paint jobs outside of just skins and things like that. I also kind of worry about what a theater mode could do for the monetization right now. And what I mean by that is, like, a good example would be borders. Like, say you're in the theater mode and you can get this unique border if you purchase this bundle, or you can get this green haze filter if you get this 420 bundle, you know, things like that. And those filters would only be utilized in theater mode, so for a majority of people buying the bundle, they're not even going to utilize the item in it, and it's just kind of like a throwaway thing that should have been there from the beginning. But yeah, that's kind of my whole concern, microtransactions when it comes to theater mode. I guess anything's possible at this point. Let me know your thoughts in the comments section below. Thank you for watching today. If you enjoyed, drop a like, subscribe for more, and I'll see you on the next one.